From the podcaster, powered by Timbre Media.
A very important subject today, and we're going to be in conversation with Mahesh Natarajan. And when I tell you what he does, you will know what the subject is all about. He's part of Innersight Counselling and Training Center based out of Bangalore. He has an MS in Counselling and Psychotherapy and quite a few counselling certifications. And he's been working with adults, adolescents, couples from diverse backgrounds, and he supports on personal growth and nurturing relationships. Also, clearly, when I got to know Mahesh, I realized he's no stranger to change at all. Just to give you one sampler, he has degrees from BITS Pilani and FMS Delhi, and then a proper career in IT and management consulting, which he then left by the side and got full time into counselling and psychotherapy. Like I said, a time like this needs people like him who know a thing or two about managing change. And change clearly has happened to us at multiple levels. To use a harsher word, uncertainty is part of our life. Most of us have more questions than we have answers to, but luckily for us, people like Mahesh have answers, some of them at least, for us today. Thank you so much, Mahesh, for joining us on this podcast. How are you doing? You know, that's a question that I ask everybody with more feeling these days.
Yeah, it's a good question to start with any conversation at these times especially. And thank you. I'm doing quite well and keeping my mental well-being up and running for sure.
Yeah.
And yes, it's a good time to be here and talk about these things, as these are quite important, especially when we are locked down against our collective will.
Right.
And knowing that it is a necessity for our collective well-being.
Right. Absolutely. You know, Mahesh, it's not just about the COVID outbreak itself. You know, of course, we are concerned about what if I fall ill and what will happen? Is there a treatment for me, etc.? But there's changes to life, and most of us have been challenged out of comfort zones, whether it's working from home, social distancing. We're having to learn new ways of doing things. So if I were to ask you, what is so specific, or what are the stressors specific to the times that we are living in that we should all be watchful for?
Yeah, I think it's three things specifically that actually has made this quite challenging. I would put it as three C's, control, choice, and competence.
Okay.
This is a situation where we don't have particular control on. We don't know when this will be over. We don't understand what this is. And so many things that are outside our control. And that is a particular challenge in itself.
Right.
The second thing is choice. We don't have a choice in being locked down. We don't have a choice in where we are locked down. If we are in Bangalore and we're locked down, we have to stay here. We can't pick up a flight and go off to meet our parents in Chennai or Delhi or something.
Right.
The third thing is competence. Because so many of us are shut up at home, we are having to do many things that we may not have competence on. So many of us are having to cook when we don't know how to cook. So many of us are having to do household work when we typically outsourced it. And other things that we are competent on, we can't do now. So people that who used to do their Zumba routines or be in cult fit or some other space can't access those things, and to then have to build up new competencies.
Right.
To develop life skills all over again. So these three things between choice, control, and competence is what actually makes life difficult right now, especially in this crisis, which is a very different crisis than like Chennai floods in 2015 or the Bhuj earthquake in so many years back.
Yeah.
Or any of the other things, or even the Surat plague
in the 90s, Yeah. So, I mean, although, like you rightly pointed out, we have had, other calamities befall us as a country, at least, but nothing on the same, quite the scale. It's been a great leveler in that sense of the word. And I don't mean this positively, because it clearly has wreaked havoc on most of our lives. But the one thing I wanted to also check with you, Mahesh, are there any particularly vulnerable groups? COVID, we've been told, the elderly, people who are who have other comorbidities, etc. But what about mental wellbeing? Being or dangers to mental well-being? Who is more
from a mental well-being perspective? Certainly, there are some populations which are much more vulnerable than others. Some especially stand out being people who are living alone in a city which they are unfamiliar with, especially for women living in PGs and other spaces where many of their flatmates and others might have left, and they find themselves alone in a large building.
Right.
Those kind of vulnerabilities are there. And certainly people who are in crowded spaces, living in urban slums or low-income spaces where they can't necessarily maintain physical distance but are so conscious of it, makes them a lot more anxious about how they would safeguard their health.
Right.
That is another category. A third category is people who are queer or LGBT people who are living in families where they are not really respected or welcome.
Right.
And that stresses also to kind of talk about women and others who might be in situations where they are vulnerable to domestic violence or sexual violence. And you know, many such people who we don't necessarily think of on an ongoing basis because they do manage like safe spaces for themselves outside,
right,
are now stuck in domestic situations where they are not safe. Both in a physical sense and in terms of their emotional well-being, where they might be subject to a lot more of verbal violence, physical violence, sexual violence, all kinds of things.
Right.
And that changes how people have to take care of their mental well-being in this time.
Right, absolutely. So that's an understanding that Mahesh has given us on the vulnerable groups, and he's also told us about the three C's, which are the contributing factors, the key ones at least, so we can set off this conversation. There's more, of course, to ask Mahesh Natarajan. He's here with us. He's part of Innersight Counselling and Training Centre. It's a collective of counsellors and doing some great work in the city of Bangalore and beyond. Stay with us.
From the podcaster, powered by Timbre Media.